Hey guys, this is Module 3, Unit 3, Lesson 6. Hopefully you're watching this and it's Tuesday, April 21st. Now this is gonna be a pretty short video. Pretty much I'm just gonna explain the directions to you and then you're gonna go to the Google Doc and then complete the assignment. So your learning target is, I can plan a broadside that states an opinion and has reasons that are supported by facts and details. So in our last lesson, we walked through a model of a broadside. We broke it down into what components were in the intro, the proof paragraphs, the conclusion, and today you're gonna plan that out. So before we jump into writing the broadside, we're gonna make sure that we organize our thoughts and so that we're ready to start that writing process. So here is the chart from the last lesson. Pretty much, you have to remember that your broadside is going to be from the point of view of a patriot. So you are not a student in Kaumba, you are not a fourth grader, you are not in Delaware, but you are a colonist who is a patriot during the American Revolution. So you have to think about, what would a patriot think? What side are they on? What do they want? Right? What do they believe in? And so in your introduction, you're going to give some background knowledge of the American Revolution, kind of talk about what's going on at that time. And then you're going to say your opinion. So as a patriot, so if you are a patriot, what does a patriot believe? Then in your proof paragraph one, you're going to give a reason. So you're going to say, why do I have that opinion? What is it? What reason do I have for that? And then give details or explain that reason. And in proof paragraph two, you're going to give a completely different reason from proof paragraph one. Okay. And then as a conclusion, you're going to kind of wrap it all up. So you're going to remind the reader what your opinion is, and then call to action is, what do you want the reader to do? So now that you told them what your side is, what is it that you want them to do? And ideally, you'd probably want them to join your side, to maybe believe what you believe, to support your cause. So you're going to have to write that out, right? What is your call to action? So this is the note catcher that you're going to fill out. So at the top, it says name. You're going to type in your name in this box right here. Then here are the directions, and they're highlighted. It says, answer each question in the charts to plan your broadside. So here is your focus question. So the question is, should colonists support the American Revolution and why? And by support, should they agree with the American Revolution? So should they agree with colonists going against Great Britain and wanting freedom? So if you say yes, you're going to have to put that in a sentence. Should colonists support the American Revolution? Yes, colonists should support the American Revolution. Or no, colonists should not support the American Revolution. And then tell me why. Why should they not, why should they support the American Revolution, or why should they not support the American Revolution? And again, this is not your personal opinion. It's not, does Miss Ligueras think that the colonists should support the American Revolution? It's, if Miss Ligueras is a patriot, would she think that you should support the American Revolution? Okay, so you're going to put your focus statement there. Okay, in the introduction paragraph, there are three questions. So the first question is, how will you catch the reader's attention? So what are you going to say in that first sentence that's going to be interesting enough to make the reader want to keep reading, right? You don't want something boring like, join the patriot side, support the American Revolution, or don't support the American Revolution, and be something so boring that people are going to pass by. Remember, these are times of war, right? An American Revolution is happening. So people don't necessarily have time to sit there and read a whole lot of information. But if you give something catchy, they might take their time to make sure that they read your broadside, right? So you got to have something that is catchy, that is interesting to make the reader want to stay and read, okay? Then number two says, what context or background knowledge do you need to give the reader? So what type of information do they need to have about the American Revolution to understand your opinion? Okay. And then number three, that is you stating your opinion. What do you think as a patriot? And hint, you can use your focus statement as your opinion. Okay. Proof paragraph one, what is one reason for your opinion? So you're going to write, what is one reason? So if in the introduction paragraph, you're saying, my opinion is blah, 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 blah. One reason I have that opinion is because, or one reason I have this opinion is blank. And then number two, what evidence or facts do you support your reason? So that's where you're going to explain it. You're going to explain your reason. So in the model paragraph, it said, The reason was everyone should be treated equally. And then the facts or evidence was equality means this. If I choose a side, then I'm saying that one is better than the other. And then that means they're not equal, right? So one reason, and then facts to support that reason. And then number three says, how does your evidence support the reason? So you're going to fill that out. Okay. Proof paragraph two is pretty much the exact same thing as proof paragraph one, except this is a second reason. So you're not going to repeat the same reason. You can't say, like the Quaker one, you can't say, oh, I believe in nonviolence. And then in the second paragraph, keep talking about nonviolence. It has to be a completely separate reason. So you're going to give a different reason in proof paragraph two and answer the other questions. And then the conclusion is to wrap it all up. So you're going to say, restate your focus statement or your opinion from the introduction paragraph in another way. So you're not going to say, my opinion is blank, and it's the same exact words from the first paragraph. You need to tell them your opinion, but in a different way, reword it. And number two is, how will you call the reader to action? So what is the sentence that you're going to write to convince them to agree with you? What is it that you want them to do? Okay, so I want you to make sure that you are not rushing through this assignment. Do not just write any answer in this. Make sure you're taking your time. You're thinking about your reasons. You're thinking about your opinion. You're thinking about, how are you going to call the reader to action? How are you going to get them to even read your broadside to begin with? Okay, because once you organize your thoughts and you figure out what you want to do, once we start writing, everything will be a lot easier. But if you just rush through this, first of all, it's not going to help you, and it's definitely not going to give you a good grade. So make sure that you are taking your time and you are thinking this through. Bye, guys.